So Rundown Studio is a run-of-show tool for keeping your productions on time. But before we get any further into that, let's take a look at the current state of Rundown documents that you've probably already worked with. We've all been on shows where we get the plan of action in some random PDF document, or maybe printed and handed to you on the day of a show. What we're trying to solve here is this hassle of reprinting documents, people scribbling notes everywhere, or teams just falling out of sync as they try to find whatever page they're supposed to be on right now. With Rundown Studio, we've moved all this onto the cloud, so your entire team can always be in sync with the latest information as you run through your show. Here in this example rundown, you can see a list of cues, and each one contains a duration, start and end time. And these times are calculated within the app, so if you make a change, for example here, I'll make this production portion 5 minutes longer, all the cues ahead of that will have a new start and end time. So how do you get your rundown data into Rundown Studio? Well, of course you can build your entire show within our tool, setting the titles, timings, and notes, but we wanted to make it even easier with our CSV import. When your client links you to a Google Sheet or maybe a Microsoft Excel document, you can export that as CSV, then upload that to Rundown Studio and we'll take it from there. We pull all the data from that upload and then add some AI magic on top to extract the end times, start times, durations, and add some organizational info to build out your rundown. This usually takes a minute or two and we'll send an email when it's done. Here's that same CSV I just uploaded, now converted into a rundown. From here, I can make all the changes that I might need. For example, here I will change the audio column and make all the mic selections super clear. I'll just highlight mic 1 in red, mic 2 in purple, and so on. Anyone on your Rundown Studio team does already have access to this full rundown, but if you want to add a client or a freelancer to follow along, then here's how. For my client, I'm happy for them to see most of the rundown, but they don't really need access to the GFX and audio columns, since these contain specific cue informations for those departments. So I'll just uncheck those, and then I can send this link, and they can open it and see the content that I've allowed them to see. Pretty nice. For the freelancer that I've hired to run GFX, I want them to see the column, but I also want them to be able to edit that column. This way they can add any specifics they need to hit their cues. I know the GFX ops, for example, likes to add some images, so I'll make sure that they can edit that column. Now I can share this link with them, and then on their computer, they have edit access to that column. They can drag and drop images into the cells as a nice reference of what graphic they should show. Finally, I have an empty slot here on my multi-view that I might want to fill with some rundown information. In the output tab, I can choose the layout that best suits me and open this up on a Raspberry Pi or some computer I have in my system. This way, as we run through the show, I will see the current queue nice and clear, and I can also see how much time is left on that queue. I could even send this output to a downstage monitor for a speaker to keep track of their time on stage. When it comes to show day, I've sent all the links to the right people. They can open up the links and see any changes I make right up until the last minute or even during the show itself. I can start my show with a start button and then let the whole production unfold as it usually would. I can always jump to the next queue when the time's right, or jump ahead in the production by queuing up a future queue and then jumping to that. And we know that rundowns can change basically at any time, even during the show, and that's why we've kept it as dynamic and real-time as possible. In fact, while the show is going on here, I can update the next queue, maybe make it longer. I can also update its title, and you can see on the output side that things are changing fast. I can even grab a queue from later and move it up earlier in the rundown and queue that up next. If you do want to export your rundown out of Rundown Studio, maybe you want to grab a local copy for going offline, or maybe there is that one person on the team that just loves a printed copy, you can do that with the PDF export. Back in Share and Export, I can use the PDF tab to grab a landscape or even a portrait copy that contains all the timing, notes, and a full color highlights that were added. I particularly like this landscape orientation, which can easily show up to 10 columns side by side with all the information super clear. All right, that's your quick look at Rundown Studio and how you can use it to keep your next production on time. We're super keen to hear any thoughts and feedback on the tool, so do sign up for an account on the website, play around, and send those thoughts to us via the site. Or if you want to stay up to date with Rundown Studio, maybe see the regular webinars that we're hosting, or grab the freebies that we're giving out, like these guides and helpful tools that we're building, then do sign up over on the site, and you can be up to date with that stuff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.